Hi, I would like to talk to you about the Navajo Code Talkers, their background history, and the National Navajo Code Talkers Day. It'll be coming up soon, and I would like to inform a lot of people who don't know about them. Many of you viewing may not know who they even are, and if you do, that's great. If not, that's okay, but please stick around and learn more about them, and just learn about them, period. I'm also trying to get the National Navajo Code Talkers Day up on the calendar so they can be honored and remembered on that day, which I'll talk about later on. The Navajo Code Talkers helped us win World War II. The first original 29 Navajos were recruited, and they had to come up with a code in their own language, and they had to use specific, like they had to get the military words and their own Navajo words and try to fit which ones best would belong together. So they had to find a word for fighter plane, grenade, a soldier, all that sort of stuff. So they created a code from their language, and it's a really hard language to learn in the first place. Of course, to them, it's the easiest thing, because they've grown up with it and it's their language, but to us outsiders it's really difficult, and you have to pronounce everything correctly, and if you don't, it means something completely different than what you're trying to say. But not even the best Japanese decoders could decipher the messages that the Navajo Code Talkers had put out. The Navajos, well, all of the Native American indigenous people had a lot of conflict and war with the government in the past. Wars had gone on, and a lot of bad things happened, but despite the history, the Navajos helped. And as one Navajo Code Talker had said in a now-deleted video, sadly, but he had said in the interview, "I think the Navajo tribe, I think they did the right thing because of how badly they were treated in the past. They were still willing to protect their land. They were willing to protect people that punished them, willing to protect people that conquered them. There is no Code Talker that would say, the heck with that, the heck with the United States, the heck with America. They're going to say, this is my mother, this is my land, this is my everything that I have right here." And I believe that was Chester Nez, if not, I might be mistaken, because like I said, the video is now deleted and I can't look back on that. But many of you may know about Wounded Knee, not the one that happened later on in the 1970s around there, but the one that happened back in 1890. It's also known as the Wounded Knee Massacre. They had gone and attacked the native/indigenous people, and they cut them up with machetes. They killed men, women, and children while they were in their sleeps late at night. They threw the babies up in the air and bayoneted them. I read also in Bury My Heart at Wounded Knee that they had exterminated an entire tribe through a war. And but they tried making the natives and indigenous people civilized, or what they called civilized. They had to speak the way they spoke, they had to speak their language, they had to wear the clothes that they wore, and if they didn't go along with it, they were called savages, and they were killed. They made them slaves, and then they put them in boarding schools, and they were either government or Christian operated. They wouldn't let the children see their parents or their families for 4 or more years, and they had to cut their hair. They were forced to cut their hair. They had to change their clothing, change the name for English ones, and they had to stop speaking their languages. If they didn't stop speaking their languages and they were caught, or, you know, they were beaten, and their mouths were washed out with, as Chester Nez had recalled in an interview, he said, a bitter brown soap. Their mouths were washed out with that. And they also believed that if they baptized the native and indigenous people, then they would go to heaven. As Chester Nez, one of the original Navajo code talkers, he was one of the original 29, had said in an interview back in 2006, all those years telling you not to speak Navajo and then to turn around and ask us for help with that same language, it still kind of bothers me, and I can see why. I've done a lot of research on the boarding schools, and I've heard a lot of history about the Native Americans, and it being a part of my history, it's very bothersome. It's not something that's really just normal. You know what I mean? Like, it's just, they did that, and then to go turn around and ask for their help, and yet still, many years later, in a lot of TV shows and just with a lot of people talking, they were still very prejudiced. A lot of people, and I've spoken to a lot of grown-ups these past few months, they know nothing of the Navajos helping us out in World War II and helping us win the war. I've had to tell many 50-year-olds and 40-year-olds about the Navajo code talkers, and I've had to tell them of what I know and of what I've learned, not only from a lot of research, but also from a class that I had taken in school this previous year. And it's really disappointing and sad how many people don't know, because, I mean, if they don't know, then their children certainly don't know, and those children's children certainly don't know. And there aren't many people who know about the Navajo Code Talkers, and that's really disappointing, considering that all a lot of people think about the Code Talkers is that they, or not even the Code Talkers, just Natives, is that they were discriminated against. But even people back then didn't really realize what they were doing. But after a while, back to the boarding schools, the Native and indigenous people had no choice in sending their children to the boarding schools because there were no other schools available for them. The whole point of the boarding school was to eliminate their traditional way of life and replace them with their American culture. Their religious practices were and everything, the way they lived. But their religious practices were forcibly replaced with Christianity, and they were taught that their culture was inferior. And the teachers made fun of their cultures, their ways of living, and everything. And they made the kids so ashamed to be Native and indigenous. The boarding schools had a bad effect on the self-esteem of Indian students and on the well-being of Native American cultures, Native languages and cultures. However, this is one thing that I will say, okay, the boarding school is good for. But I'm not saying the boarding school was good. It was horrible. Especially from all of the research that I have read on, it's not that. It's not even should be looked up upon. I mean, yes, some of the memories were not bad. The natives made friends for life. They made skills that they would later on find helpful, like carpentry, cooking, science, math, agriculture, and trading. And the military, or the boarding school life, was like military life. And they had to wear uniforms and march in transformations. And that helped them later on in the military when they joined. But that doesn't give you the right to treat them so horribly, to beat them and to wash their mouths out with soap and tell them that their culture was inferior. That's not right. It's not something that should have been done. Because, I mean, look at, years later, we needed their help. And they saved our butts from losing the war. We were really close to losing World War II. The Japanese decoded every single one of our messages that we had put out. But during not only World War II, but World War I as well, that the native indigenous languages were used to send secret military messages. I didn't even know that in World War I they had used languages, natives, to help. And it was near the end of the war. But the languages that were used were Cherokee, Cheyenne, Choctaw, Comanche, Osage, and Yankton Sioux. They transmitted messages by telephone, and that helped play a key role in the war, helping the U.S. Army win many of the battles in France, and that helped the war come to an end. In World War II, there were many languages used. Aside from Navajo, there are 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, and 18. They used 18 languages to help in World War II. In 1941 and 1942, that's where the Navajos were in the Marine Corps. So in 41 and in 42, the Marine Corps started recruiting the Navajo code talkers. And the idea had come from a man named Philip Johnston, who was a missionary son and World War I veteran, who had heard about the success of the Choctaw that they had doing the same thing by telephone, and he had brought it up on a Navajo reservation, and he brought it up to the military, and he was actually raised on a Navajo reservation, and he spoke Diné. He spoke the Navajo language. And a lot of the Navajos that were recruited had lied about their age. There were many as young as 15 years old going into the war just to fight. But there were more than 12,000 American Indians served in World War I, about 25% of the male American Indian population at that time. And during World War II, when the total American Indian population was less than 350,000, an estimated 44,000 Indian men and women served. It wasn't only the adult Navajos that had served. Like I had said, there were teenagers too, as young as 15 years old. 420 Navajos served in World War II, and fortunately, many Navajos still speak their language today and continue to speak it for future generations, and there are over 250,000 tribal members. As the war continued to progress and a Navajo code was adopted, the Navajo, they had created a Navajo code talking school. And as more and more Navajos came in and started learning the codes, eventually more than 400 Navajos were recruited as code talkers who enlisted and those who were drafted into the war. And there were many code talkers from 16 different tribes who served in the Army, the Marines, and the Navy. The code talkers were spread out all over to serve in World War II. The Navajos and the Hopi were located in the Pacific to fight against the Japanese. The Comanches fought against the Germans in Europe. And the Meskwakis, I'm not sure how to pronounce that one, fought the Germans in North Africa. Many other code talkers from other tribes fought in many other locations as well. And the Navajo code talkers were huge targets for snipers and anyone because of the huge bulky radios. that they had carried around with them. Not only did they translate the messages and send them out, but they also had to know how to operate both the wire and the radio equipment, carry it on their backs, and know how to set up and maintain the electronic wires and lines. And there was this one code talker, again, on the deleted video, who had said he and this other man were in a hutch, you know, like, that covered them from sight. And there was a window so that they could look out. But he told him, he says, hey, you know, to the Navajo code talker, he says, don't sit there. He says, because he's directly under the window and his huge bulky radio is right next to him. He says, you're going to be an easy target and you're going to get shot and killed. He says, so let's trade places. And just as they had switched and the man had sat down where that Navajo code talker was, he got shot and killed. And the code talker, he had felt so guilty, he says, because that he was sitting there, that bullet was meant for him, and that it should have been him lying there dead, not that man. As a code talker had said in another video that I have seen, he said that his commanding officer had told all of the other people, he says, I want you to protect this Indian. He says, because he holds something that is very important. Now, I'm not saying the exact words from the videos because I can't remember them off of the top of my head, but he did say he wanted that Indian to be protected. He wanted them to be protected because they held a language so delicate that was going to help us win World War II, and we could not lose that. 40 years later, after Iwo Jima, Pearl Harbor, and the Navajo code talkers, 40 years into the future, in 1982, the then President Ronald Reagan had declared August 14th the National Navajo Code Talkers Day, and it's still not seen anywhere on any calendar. People still cease to know about the Navajo Code Talkers and what they have done for their country, for our country, and no one honors or celebrates or remembers them. We have President's Day. We have Martin Luther King Jr. Day. We have Labor Day. But what about celebrating the Navajos and all of the code talkers who helped us win World War II? I mean, it's not known. As I've said before, a lot of people don't know about it. A lot of you viewing probably didn't know about it until just now. And to know that there's a day for them specifically that no one knows about, it's kind of sad. I want to try and get August 14th on the calendar. I want to try and get them to be recognized for everything that they have done for us, risking their lives. As I had read previously, the natives, indigenous people, were not that violent. They protected their land, they protected their families and their tribe. So if anyone tried to threaten them or tried to kill them, they automatically became an enemy because they tried killing them off and threatening them and their land. But they would lay down their lives for their tribe members. They would lay down their lives because they cared so much about it, so much about each other. They would lay down their lives for others. And yet, a lot of people have discriminated against them, they've been prejudiced against them, and they were seen as inferior. You know, they're not talked about in any school. My school that I've only been going to for about maybe 2 years now, going on 3 years soon, this August, is the only school that I have ever known of to talk about the Native Americans, indigenous people, to talk about the Navajo Code Talkers and what they did in World War II. Yes, I learned about Pocahontas back in middle school, but in my history book, she looked white to me. She had green eyes, her hair was kind of dark, but not really, and she had light skin. Why didn't she look like a real Native American in that picture? Because white people wrote it. They wrote the history in the American books. What I learned this past year about them is from what I've learned from a 20th century history videotape that was made way back in the 90s that talked about Pearl Harbor and the Code Talkers. And I've researched for my project interviews from all of the Navajo Code Talkers that I could find. And it's just sad that no one knows about them. So I'm trying to get the word out, and I'm trying to spread the word about the Navajo Code Talkers, and I'm trying to spread the word about August 14th. August 14th is the National Navajo Code Talkers Day, and they deserve to be honored, they deserve to be remembered, and they deserve to be celebrated on that day. The Native Americans, indigenous people, they celebrate them on powwows. They'll walk in there with the flags. You know, I've seen them walk right before the powwow dancers because I've gone to powwows. And they celebrate their veterans. They honor their veterans deeply. And why can't we do that for them as well? You know, we celebrate everybody else. We celebrate everyone. Oh, Columbus Day. You know how he founded the Americas? He didn't. He came in and the indigenous Native American people were here already. But he killed them. You know, he started a war against them. And then Spaniards came, the Anglo-Saxons, they came, and ever since then, the natives have been fighting to protect themselves, to protect their tribes, and to protect their land. So, obviously, this subject gets me very upset, and I hope learning about this new information, that you spread it around, and that you tell people about it, and that you make sure that they are known. Let's honor and celebrate and give thanks for the Native and Indigenous people. Let's honor, celebrate, and give thanks to the many Code Talkers, Navajo Code Talkers, who gave their lives, who died for us, and who saved our asses from losing World War II. Let's educate people about the Navajo Code Talkers and all the other old Code Talkers about them, telling them. And let us tell our children about it. Let us tell our siblings and our cousins and our aunts and our uncles and just everybody, our friends, about who they were, what they did, and why we need to celebrate them on that day. even if you don't think about them for an entire year, except for on that one day, at least you remember them, and at least you know what they did for us. Celebrate August 14th in honor of them. Please. Celebrate none of them, because they certainly do deserve it.